Thank you for watching Chitaruba Yoga and Fitness. I'm Laura Wilson, teaching you ways to adapt yoga poses so that everybody can find a way to do their thing. Today we're going to do 15 minutes of yoga all in our chair. We're not going to stand up. We're not getting on the floor. It's not going to be terribly strenuous. Maybe. We'll see. Make sure you have a nice straight chair on a non-slick surface, clear area to work out in. While you're getting ready, just a reminder, please ask your friends to subscribe to my channel. If you like the video, hit that button underneath. And let me know in the comments if you like yoga all in the chair like this, it's just a few minutes, or if you prefer a regular traditional mat class or something that's a little more of a combination. All right? When we're ready, let's go ahead and get tall in our chair, about halfway forward on those sit bones. We want our knees about hip distance apart, which is two fists. And angles underneath our knees. Let's tuck shoulders over hips, lengthen our spine, and we'll start with our eyes closed. So if you're taking a little break at the office for these 15 minutes, this should be a good one for you. And we're just gonna begin rolling ourselves forward, shoulders coming forward, and then lifting up shoulders, going back. Roll it forward and back. So we want to feel our whole spine and everything else attached to it, hips and shoulders. And we're going to lengthen up, extend one leg, opposite hand, reach up, lean a little bit. Let's bring it up, switch sides. So let's come back up, we'll leave this leg out so we can take the same side hand, see how that feels. Switch sides. Let's come back, reach back. We're gonna open up through our heart. Let's drop our head over one side. Taking this to the other side. Lifting up, let's take a look over one shoulder and then the other. Coming back to the center. Now let's just do a little easy twisting. We're gonna work from our waist and just turn side to side. Letting our arms flow. Let's come back to the center. Taking our arms up, turning our palms, let's bring it down. Turn and lift. One thing about yoga, it's all our own body, so that is cool. And we're going to scoot back a little bit, take our legs out wide, hands onto the chair. So we're going to get a little upper body warm-up and some lower body warm-up by doing some chair squats or just lifting up an inch or so. Pressing the weight onto our arms. If we're scooting back far enough on a sturdy chair, we should be safe here. Using our legs and our arms. Getting a good body weight workout here. One more. And then we'll lift up, press open, bring our heart forward. And we're going to drop one shoulder across to the opposite knee. Let's take it to the other side. So let's lift up from here, bring our legs in. And we're going to take a giant step off to one side, find that corner of our chair, adjust ourselves so that this thigh is on the chair, drop this knee forward. And we'll take our other arm to the back of our chair. And then, listening to our own body, let's wiggle this leg back to where we feel a stretch across the front of our hip. And then just let our body work its way into that stretch. We can give ourselves a little bit of a massage here. Just an easy punch here, an easy shiatsu, I guess. If you even want to add that. And we'll take this forward arm, we'll reach it up, and then side bend over the back of the chair, pushing our hips out toward the screen. And lifting up, and let's just bring our hands around to the back of the chair. Don't pull, just set our hands there.
See what's in the back of our room. And let's unwind this. We'll bring this leg in. Come forward again. Let's take this out wide. Seeing how things feel here. And we'll bring this together, stepping out to the other side. So we find that corner here, shifting onto this thigh so this knee can come down. And then wiggling back, whatever amount feels right. Just till we feel that stretch here. And again, we can add our little massage if we want to. Feeling wherever we're tight in that hip. And then we'll take this arm up and side, bend backwards, pressing down through this hip to accentuate that side stretch. Coming up tall for our spine, just twisting so that our hands just place them on the chair, looking over our shoulder. Now let's unwind this, we'll bring it back. And this time we're going to take our heels to the edges of our chair, scoot back a little bit, lengthen up tall. We're going to reach our arms forward for our chair pose. But this, the literal translation is powerful pose. It looks like we're sitting in a chair, so people call it that. But it's powerful pose. So let's see if we can find a little power today. Lifting ourselves, oops, just an inch or so off of the chair. Ooh. And let's release. Bring that. So we're going to come a little further forward on our chair. We're going to take this to a variation of our pyramid, extending our right leg straight, right arm up. And we're going to revolve this, taking our hand down to our knee. Other hand should fit on the chair, the seat of the chair behind us. We can gaze at the wall or out over our shoulder. Let's flex the toes and foot of our extended leg. Unwinding from here. Let's reach forward. And as we're feeling it, we can take this forward any amount. We can rest ourselves, brace ourselves on the other leg. Bringing this back up. Let's bring that leg in, extend the other one out, reaching up, extending every part of our body. Taking this to a twist, other hand to the chair right behind us, gazing at the wall or the back wall. Flexing through the toes and foot of our extended leg. Unwind that, reaching forward, and then if we're feeling it, we can take it further here, 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 whatever helps us feel that stretch to the back of our leg. Remember, flex your toes, breathe. And let's lift this up, scooting back a little bit in our chair. We'll take it out wide. Let's take one arm to our thigh, reaching up. Option to lower this a little bit more. Remember, shoulder over shoulder. Let's take this hand down around behind us. Keeping that hand on our back, let's lift up. And we're going to reach our other arm up and back. If you can clasp your fingers, excellent. But if not, that's okay. Just flex on your back. And we'll look up to our elbow. Breathe. breathing.
And releasing. So let's take it to the other side, extending up. Perhaps lowering down a little bit, maybe not. We'll take this other arm around behind our back. And let's lift up from here, keep that hand on our back, reach the other arm up and back, looking at our elbow. And let's release from here. We'll bring our legs back in. Scoot forward on our chair as far as we're comfortable going and still being on our chair. Let's roll our shoulders back. Hold on to the back of our chair and really open up here. Feeling our heart expand. Taking our chin up toward the corner where the wall meets our ceiling. Let's release from here, sitting back a little bit. You know we're going to do this one, crossing at the ankle and coming forward, or at our knee. Just don't press this knee down. Allow it to be natural. We're feeling that stretch to our hip. Sit up from here. We'll take both hands over to the other side of our chair. Easy twist here. Unwind and then switch sides. So ankle, bring it forward or at the knee. Making sure that we just feel discomfort. We shouldn't feel pain. Just some discomfort as it stretches. It's good for us. Lifting it up, and let's easy twist this to the other side. Let's scoot back in our chair. We're going to just extend our feet forward. Let's flex and point. Try some rotation of everything here. Spreading our fingers and toes, scrunching them up, spreading them out. Now let's just shake everything out. We're going to take a moment of relaxation here, making sure to add some cushioning at our back here. We can even scoot our chair to a wall and let our head rest against the wall. Allowing our heads, hands to rest on our lap for a moment. And just while we're in the chair, let's feel our legs sink heavy into it. Our shoulders sink toward the floor. We can keep our head neutral, or again, we can back up to a wall and let our head rest at the wall, which would be neutral. Softening our belly. Softening our face. If we are in an office or if we've had a busy day, taking a few minutes of quiet just resets our body, resets our mind. Before we start to move, let's just take a few deep breaths into our belly. And then move our fingers and toes and everything else. Let's sit up and take one big stretch to our whole body. that go. Take a big inhale. And let that go. Thank you for joining me again. Please do ask your friends to subscribe to the channel. And if you like it, hit that like button for me. And let me know if you like these all in the cheer workouts or if you prefer something a little more mixed. All right? I'll see you next time.